same as human, bacteria have viruses that attack them. So you have viruses that attack the cells and kill them. And the bacteria, like us, they don't want to be killed by viruses. So what happens is that they develop different mechanisms that we call immune mechanisms to fight their own viruses. And as a bacteria, you have several ways of defending yourself against viruses. You can cut a virus, you can kill yourself to prevent that the virus will duplicate and invade other cells. But what we discovered is a new way for bacteria to prevent themselves, to defend themselves against viruses. What happens is that they produce a small molecule, which is basically a poison specific for the virus. So you produce this small molecule when you're under attack, and what happens is that the virus will take into its DNA, into its RNA, and actually this will prevent the virus from dividing and replicating, and thus it's a new way for bacteria to defend themselves against their own viruses. Yes, it's a fundamental aspect of the study. This is actually how we got to this discovery in bacteria. In humans, there is this gene called Viperin that produces a toxic molecule for virus, for human viruses. And the mechanism that this gene produces this molecule was discovered a couple years ago. And when we saw the paper with the discovery, we were amazed and thought, well, maybe it also exists in bacteria. And thus, what we discovered is that when we went in and looked for these genes in bacteria, we found that it was encoded by rare bacteria, but it was. And so we took the different version of these genes, it's similar to the human one, but it's not exactly the same, and then we discovered that these genes encoded in bacteria are used by bacteria to defend themselves against viruses. And we proved that also in bacteria, basically, these genes have an antiviral function. But the very nice aspect is that it is similar to the human gene, but it's not the same. And while the human version makes one type of molecule, the bacterial ones make different ones because you have more diversity. And this is a fundamental aspect to show how studying the diversity of the immune systems of bacteria leads you to discovery into the diversity of potential antiviral molecules. When I arrived here, the first feeling was like, first, how lucky I am to do research with the place, with the sun, the palm trees, and such a beautiful campus. Like, it's amazing to come work here every day, and also very amazing resources to do science, both the resources in terms of money, but also in terms of the intellectual capabilities around me. The team that is in the lab has been absolutely incredible to generate ideas, to help me through the research, and I think this very special, really special, ambience that exists through Weizmann within the lab, this creative curiosity that for me has been really at the center of my period here, has been something fantastic and what leads to such amazing discoveries in Weizmann.